Welcome back, and this is Naveen from UiBrains. In this video we are going to see the practical example on the local storage and the session storage. Okay, so let me open WebStorm. So let me close all other things. So till now we actually made examples on Bootstrap, right? So let's make a default one. Let me copy the first this one, because it contains no Bootstrap setup, just normal HTML and CSS setup. So I want this one. Okay, I don't want to do anything Bootstrap setup and all. Just make only console logs. So I need this setup. So let me copy this folder, first folder, paste it. Let's make this as 24.js.local/session/storage. Okay, fine. Delete this. And HTML, let's make a local and session storage. So let me copy this and paste it. Okay, fine. Let me open this in a browser. Refresh. Local and session storage. Inspect console window. Okay, so no DOM manipulation here in this example. Only the console window we're gonna see the data programmatic. So let me open app.js. What we discussed in the last video is these things. Let me copy that /*, paste it. Okay, so it starts with the local storage. So now local storage for simple string. So let's start with a simple string. How can it store in the local storage? So here I say let employee name is equal to John. Okay, I have a employee name equal to John. I want to store this in a local storage of JavaScript. So how you do is, let's say local storage dot set item. You have to provide the key and value. So key is going to be the employee. Let's take employee name. Okay, employee name. But you may confuse key and value is same, right? So let's take a name. Okay, and its value is going to be the employee name. Okay, let's save it. Local storage set item. Its key is the name. Its value is the employee name is John. So let's save it. Go back to the browser. Sir, where can we see that? Local storage, actually you can see in the tab called application. Let's click on application. You can see the left side panel, local storage and session storage. Okay, so in the local storage of this, see, you have key and value. And let me clear first, refresh once. Refresh means it execute the program again. So key is name, value is John. So you have a data. Now, one small cross check. Local storage means even if you close the browser and reopens back to the URL. Yeah, back to the URL and local storage. Let me inspect and application. See, still data is there. It's called local storage. Okay, for session storage it will not be available. Fine, and you have stored some data. Next, I want to fetch the data. So this is to set get. How? So let's say console dot log of local storage dot get item, and what is the key you have to have is name is the key. Okay, so local storage dot get item name. So let's check in the console window, you got John as a its value. Next, if you want to delete it, okay, delete the key. How delete is local storage dot delete. It's not actually delete, I think. Oh, sorry, I actually made a mistake. It's not delete, it's a remove item. Okay, so small correction. It's a remove item. Okay. Yeah, local storage dot remove item. And what is item you're gonna remove is name. So as soon as you have executed this line, go check. It is printed because it's a previous line. And if you call this, go check. There is no data. So it's got deleted. Next, one more is clear. Clear means it's cleared all data. Let's say dot clear. So it's clears. Anyway, no data is there, but it clears the complete data. Fine. So this is about a plain string, right? So now I want to store an array. Okay, so how to store? So let's see local storage with an array. So here, let's take an array. Let's colors is equal to, let's take an array of white comma black comma silver and purple comma yellow. Okay, I got colors and these data I want to store to the local storage. So how to store local storage dot set item. I just pass the colors as a key. Its value is colors. Okay, actually, as I said, while storing any data, you must have to convert to a string and store. So here I have not converted to string, I'm just storing as it is. If you're storing as it is, let's see what happens in the local storage. So you see here, colors, you got data. It stores in an just like an array. Or else, do one thing, interesting thing is, yes? Not just strings like this. I'll do one thing, I'll just take an object, okay? This is nice. ID 1, okay? And the name is gonna be the white lice, comma. Let's make multiple objects inside. Okay, so here, ID 2, ID 3, ID 4. So here it is black, here it is blue, and here it is yellow. Fine, you have an array of objects. Let me do the storage. So local storage dot set item colors comma comma colors. Check what happens. See, data has stored like object 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 object. Even if you do console dot log of local storage dot get item of colors, what you gonna get as a return is all objects and not actual data. So that's why while storing you must have to convert that to an string. So how to convert this thing to string is you have a function called JSON object. It's a global object of JavaScript dot stringify of colors. So what happened? It converts to string and stores inside. Now check application. See, data has stored in a string format and you can easily understand, yes, this is our data. And when you do console.log of get item of colors, you're gonna get data like a string format. If you want to know that, see the string, actually it's not actually your array. If you want to know that, let's say type of what happened, see the string. I don't want string, I want actually a proper data. So what do you do? Let the colors is equal to json dot parse. You have to parse it. What to parse? So let me cut this, keep it here. So parse the local storage dot colors and you will make the colors. You get data properly, an array, right? You can just loop the array and you can just find out whatever you want. Okay, so thing is, if you have anything other than string, you must have to convert to string and store. While fetching, convert back to an object, okay, using the global variable, I mean global object called JSON. Okay, fine. And let me delete. So, okay, I want to delete this colors. So delete means local storage dot remove item or colors. So what happens? It clears the data. Okay, fine. This is about local storage, and let's start with the session storage. So session storage with simple string. Okay, let's take a student name is equal to, let's take Rajan. Okay, the person who logged in is Rajan, you can assume. Now I have to store, how to store session storage dot set item. So the name is gonna be the student name. Okay, save it. Now go back. So where you see that, actually here you have session storage. When I see that, see you have a name Rajan. Okay, fine. And let me comment out that, because once it is added, it will be there here. Data is there. Okay, and now because of session storage, if you close the browser, data collapse. Let's see. Let me close the browser again. Reopen. 27 9000. Come on. Yeah. Here. Let me inspect. Console, not console, app. Session storage. See, no data. If you local storage, anyway, we clear. Session storage, no data. Okay, so the session storage is like that. So let me enable again. It means it creates again. Now data is available. Okay, fine. And you wanna fetch. This is for set. For get. Get is simple console.log of console.log of session storage dot get item of name. So you get Rajan as a name. Okay, fine. You wanna delete it. Console, not console actually, session storage dot remove item of name. So without closing a browser, you can remove it from program. So go check, there is no data in a session. You can remove like this, and clear also same. You can do session storage dot clear. So how many elements are there? So all the data will be cleared out. Okay, so irrespective of the key, it removes all data. So any individual you want to clear, you can do this. You know, clear everything, do clear. Okay, fine. Let's make an array. Array same. Actually, do one thing. Let's take a same story of colors, right? Let me copy this. This is why you have to write again and again. Let's take colors, and okay, I have colors. This is gonna be the session storage dot set item and get item. Okay, go check. See, in session storage you got colors. It stores the same function, right? So same data. And you wanna fetch it? Yeah, I have fetch from the session storage, and go check, you got the same data, get from session storage. And you wanna clear it, let's say watch session storage dot remove item of colors. So session removes data. Fine, that's it. Okay, so this is all about the session storage and local storage. So I have one plan is, let's create some nice example, because with the UI. Okay, so here we just made only in the backend process manually. So let's make some UI application, so where you can really see the storage of the information. Okay, so let's see that example in the next video. Thank you.